This week's subject is consumer issues. There are a wide array of issues that can arise from making a large product purchase or repair. Let's say you can't start your lawnmower and it's just the second time you've used it in a week. Or the car is making that funny noise still, even though the mechanic assured you that the problem was fixed. Well, if that sounds familiar, you might be confronting a consumer issue. The Consumer Federation of America has indicated that most grievances that consumers have is surrounding the purchase of a used car, home improvements, vehicle repairs, mail orders, telemarketing, and credit and collection issues. So here's a quick look of some of the things you can do to help deal with this potential problem. The first tip is try to avoid the problem in the first place. You know, maybe you check things out. I used to use Consumer Report magazine all the time to try to figure out what people thought about a product. Nowadays, you can Google and get reviews, which is kind of a good way to do it. Maybe ask a friend or someone you know that has purchased the product as to what their experience has been. Finding a good service provider, another type of product, can also be challenging. Again, review the company's reputations and check with friends and get other referrals. Also, your local Better Business Bureau may be able to provide some information about complaints. Now, once you decide to buy the product or engage the service provider, make sure to read the contract, especially with service providers, before signing. It's also important to understand the terms, which include information like repayment terms, interest rates, and if the product is purchased on credits, and your rights as a consumer. The product may come with a warranty. Extended warranties can be costly. You need to ask yourself here, is it really worth it? And what about service contracts? They're another area that need careful consideration before you decide to purchase it along with the product. Is the item really likely to need this service? Well, if it isn't, you may not want to buy it. Also, using your credit card may protect you against product failures as well, or some credit cards actually double the manufacturer's warranty, or they at least increase it a certain amount. Now, speaking of credit cards, the Fair Credit Billing Act may allow the use of your card to obtain that warranty in case something goes wrong. We just talked about that. And you might also be able to withhold payment if you have a problem with the product until a complaint has been dealt with. The Consumer Credit Protection Act and the Equal Opportunity Act are other pieces of legislation designed to help consumers. These, coupled with your state's lemon laws, are there also to help. It pays to know your rights under the law. So keep in mind, the key to resolving some issues is perseverance. First, see if you're using the product properly. Well, that's happened to me a couple times. Next, register your complaint. This should be made in writing. Do this as soon as you discover the product is defective. Keep copies of all correspondence. Write the names and phone numbers of people you spoke with, dates and times of all communications pertaining to the issue. Pursue your problem within the company as far up the ladder as you can go. If that doesn't work, you may want to call the government consumer agency to help you out. Consumer action lines can assist or give advice as to how to proceed. The final resort, if all else fails, is potentially taking the person or company to small claims court. Well, good luck with your consumer issues, and hopefully everything you buy and all the services you sign up for work as well as you would like them to.